Friday night. It's time to step out on this Friday night. You acting like an old lady.
Girl, you probably right. Let me look up in the closet, see what I can wear. Check the bank account, let me see what I can spell. Baby daddy might trip, but I don't even care.
You don't ever go out, he been out all year.
Girl, you gon' get a bitch beat up.
Child, please, what time we gon' meet up?
Who took my jacket out of my closet? I guess I gotta pop off to get a response, huh? Kyrie, you ain't pop shit all year. Go sit your ass down somewhere before you get jumped. Oh, mama would love that. Savon, did you touch my fucking jacket? You come over here with that shit, it's gonna be different. I'm not in the fucking mood for you today, Kyrie. Oh, that's how y'all coming. So nobody gonna tell me where my jacket is. Bet. What the fuck? Going on in here? Mama, they just hit me and spit on me. You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Did you guys hear I have a new boyfriend?
No way.
Yeah, I know, he's like really rich. I'm sorry, Emma, what'd you say?
Oh, nothing.
Yeah, you sound like a bitch. So last weekend I was shopping at Chanel, which is my fave designer, if you couldn't tell. He walked in, he was tall, dark, and handsome, like so hot he could hold me for ransom. He told me he flew on a private jet, and I was like, okay, where are we going next? Flash forward 24, we're in Cabo, daddy's blowing up my phone, because I'm not at the chateau. One more thing I forgot to mention, he's like 20 years older, but he's got his pension. Don't laugh, he's really not that bad. Ooh, wait! Did I show you guys his bag? It's like $6,000, money's in his hand. All I do is look pretty and my wish is his command. Ooh, Mrs. Smith, I think I have to go. Why? I have a flight to catch to Mexico.
Okay, so a random embarrassing moment just popped in my head and I feel like sharing it with you guys. So I was in a mainstream class, which is a hearing class. The teacher asked for volunteers to read a book. No one volunteered, so she's like, okay, I'll pick. At that point, I'm like, whatever, I never get picked because I'm deaf, so they usually leave me alone and I'm not complaining about that. And then for the first time, she picked me. I'm like, okay, keep in mind my book is closed because I look at the interpreter, everybody else is on page. So I had to look for the page. My anxiety was through the roof, but I was like, okay, whatever, just read. So I'm like, da-da-da-da-da, and then it said Virginia the state. Everybody started cracking up. I was so lost. I look at the interpreter, she's cracking up. I'm like, hello? She's like, I'm like, what's so funny? And then she was like, you said vagina. I'm like, oh, let me just pass away. I was laughing, but then I was like really, really embarrassed at that point. And then the teacher was like, okay, calm down, guys. Let her keep reading. Keep reading. You gonna let me keep reading? I'm not gonna pass it on after that.
I'd like to know which one of you sneaky fucks drank my cranberry juice. Am I talking to myself or do I have to start swinging? Now, you know I would not touch your shit, Savon. Kyrie? What? Did you drink my cranberry juice? I didn't, but I want to know what was going to happen if I did. The fuck? Did you? Yes or no, you fucking psycho? If I say yes, what's going to happen? You going to get your ass beat. That's what's going to happen. Can you say it again for the people in the back? Kyrie, I'm going to beat your ass if you touch my shit. Savon, I know you ain't out here threatening my baby. Mama, he drank my cranberry juice. I drank it. Come beat my ass. Come here. Do what you said you was going to do to my baby. All right, mama. Yeah, okay. I guess y'all want to act brand new because y'all got a bigger house than the rest of us. Y'all still ain't shit. You talking awfully a lot of shit from my brand new installed carpet. As a matter of fact, take your shoes from Payless off, please. Fuck you in this carpet. Y'all so fucking uppity, I told my mama not to bring me over here. We told our mama not to let her. Last time you were over here, we accumulated some roaches. Brian, I will fuck you up. That has to be the virgin and you talking. We both know your bitch ass couldn't fuck shit. Your mama's a bitch. Call my mama another bitch. Call her another bitch. Tamika. What's going on? Mama, it was tragic. His face fell into Kyrie's fist. No, that's not what happened. You're right. I forgot to mention you wanted to play truth or dare and dared us to pull our pants down. No, Aunt Tamika, that's not what happened. Evan, I don't know what y'all do at y'all's house, but I don't play that shit here. Aunt Tamika, that's not true. Leave this door open, Brian.
Any bag talk? It's quiet, ain't no back talk.
Ouch. Saval, you need to tell Mama. Fuck no. Sitting here letting that burn ain't gonna make it go away. There's medication to stop the pain. If I tell Mama, I won't see the medication. I'll be 6 feet under. Ouch. Tell her. Tell me what? Mama, it burns when I pee.
Did you catch something?
I think so. Mama, that's not funny. Ouch. Looks very painful. Mama! Didn't I tell y'all to use condoms? You won't buy us any. Didn't I tell y'all to sniff it before you stick it? You say a lot of things we don't listen to, Mama. Now, can you please take me to the emergency room? Oh, no, I can't do that. I need that to burn until I feel like you've learned your lesson. Mama, please call your daddy and ask him to take you. I would if I knew who he was. I hope your shit falls off. Mama!
Would have came back for you. I just needed time.
Do you know who I think our informant is? North.
What do you mean? She told everybody?
A mom at school texts me and goes, "Congrats, I heard you're having a baby brother." And I go, "What?" And I go, "Oh, that." And she goes, "Yeah, North is going around saying she finally has a baby brother, so Saint won't bother her anymore."
Stop.
And I was like, "Oh, that's just her dream, ha ha ha." I'm like, she's the one this whole time.
That is crazy.
Yeah.
What are you
gonna do? I mean, nothing. I mean, I killed it.
I'm just kidding.
No, but I killed the rumor.
You looking for a beat in the
Oh, calm down, Jamal. Don't pull out the nine.
School was very hard.
Why?
First off, I said hi to Mr. Hamilton, and he
still don't know my name.
And then I told my crush, Connor.
Come on, Leslie.
And then he said, "You
don't stand a chance."
Then I said,
"Let me offer this as a rebuttal.
I don't cook, I don't clean,
but I am a girl." Yes, I did. But then he told me to
cram.
And then I fell in gym class and
hurt my left knee.
And the cute new boy came to help me up.
And then
I didn't know what to say, so I just blurted out,
"Like you cut, G."
Kyrie, why did I receive a phone call from your teacher earlier? I don't know. She said she told you to stop talking while she was teaching, and you told her to shut her fat neck having ass up and to go eat a fucking Snickers. Oh, that's funny. Mama, he gives Miss Platypus problems all the time. You'll regret that. Brian, did I ask you for any extra information? Kyrie, you better start talking or I'm gonna get in that ass. Mama, there was no reason for me to say what I said. I am so sorry. There's nothing I can say to justify me disrespecting that lady. As punishment, I give you my phone, and I won't be playing my game for a week. Don't let it happen again. It won't. Hell nah, Mama. Hell nah. Beat his ass. Who the fuck are y'all talking to like that?
If you wanna see some wet ass pussy.
Named Michael used to ride motorcycles. Dick bigger than a tower. I ain't talking about Eiffels. Real country ass nigga, let me play with his rifle. Pussy put his ass to sleep. Now we calling me Nyquil. Now that bang, bang, bang.
So lately I've been seeing a lot of videos talking about hair by Chrissy, so I wanted to share my experience with them. This happened in August. I emailed the salon asking for Chrissy. She's like, sure, what kind of hair do you have? And I said like wavy curly, because I have naturally curly hair, but it was damaged, so it was kind of wavy. Looking back, she probably thought I meant white girl wavy. No. So anyway, she was like, sure. She gave me the phone number to contact Chrissy's manager, which I did. We talked back and forth. And then she asked me to send pictures of my natural hair and what I wanted my hair to look like. So I sent her a picture of me and my natural hair, which was curly, wavy, and then curly extensions, which I wanted my hair to look like. And then I heard nothing. So after 3 days of talking to me, sending her pictures of my hair, she like completely ghosted me out of the blue. I'm like, oh, okay. 2 days later, I contacted her again, like, what's up? Are we good? Still nothing. I'm like, you know what? Let me look at her Instagram page. I'm going through the pictures. I'm like, oh, my bad. That's the type of hair she does.